everybody. Welcome back to the podcast, My View on the View, where I make the views table relatable. Come on in. We got a lot to talk about. Come on. Okay, guys, I could not wait to connect with y'all today when I saw this because I was like, this makes perfect sense to me. Now I kind of understand what I was seeing with those 2 days that Ebony was there. I didn't really know what was going on behind the scenes until this story came out, okay? So listen, it's very important that if you didn't hear the 7-point review of Ebony K. Williams' two days of chemistry testing on The View, that you listen to that first, because I mentioned on there why I was suspicious and like just wondering what the heck was really going on during those 2 days for her, okay? But I want to tell you something. Just a few days ago, okay, the Daily Mail released an exclusive story. The bulk of this story talked about how allegedly a friend of Ebony came to them and said that Ebony is telling people, allegedly, that she doesn't want the conservative seat. She really wants Sunny's seat, okay? Now, you can Google this article, and I'm going to let you read all that. I will just tell you that, you know, normally I dive into all of these articles with y'all, but I'm not going to do it on this one because it's very clear to me, the more and more I look at these types of things, that I need to be careful that I don't join my platform with others who are pitting two Black women against each other. I just won't do that. And so I'm not even going to indulge in that part of the article because I don't believe that. And I believe that these people are just doing what a lot of us in the Black community have had done to us. We've seen it done in the workplace with other Black women. If there are two educated, you know, highly intelligent Black women, somehow or another, people try to pit these two women against each other. Same thing that people tried to do with Sunny Hostin and Condoleezza Rice. And I refuse to participate in that either, okay? But what was interesting to me in this exclusive is what allegedly the insiders at The View told the Daily Mail about Ebony's 2 days. Because remember, I kept saying to you guys, this was the weirdest thing to me. Because why would you hire someone, I gave you all this example, hire someone to paint a beautiful picture, and yet all they do when they come to the job is like wash windows. It's like, I thought you told me they were a great painter. I haven't even had a chance to see that because you've not had them paint nothing, you know? So let me read some specific quotes to y'all from this article, okay? Again, we don't know who the insider was, but allegedly this is what they told the Daily Mail. Quote, "The problem is Ebony is just a chameleon for whatever job she's trying to get. She knows she can't carry the conservatives." According to the network sources, the idea of bringing the Roni star on full time has already been ruled out by ABC. Also, the person said, "We have zero interest in hiring Ebony because we want a real conservative, not someone who played one on Fox News for a minute." When I read these things from this, you know, insider, I will tell you, I thought, now it makes sense to me why they did Ebony that way. You know, I don't know why they even reached out to Ebony in the beginning, several months back, and invited her to come chemistry test if they already knew they didn't want to associate The View with anything Bravo, you know, any Housewives, you know, related stuff. Why would they have reached out to her anyway? Okay. But I think there was one stream of thinking when they initially reached out to her. And then for some reason, okay, the executives at The View decided against that. And so they already knew they weren't going to offer this girl a seat anyway. So now it makes sense to me. Those 2 days she was on there, two friggin' days back to back, and they hardly talked about anything political at all. They kept it nice and sweet. They kept it real lighthearted. It makes sense to me now because they're not looking at her. They weren't looking at her really to test out for that chair. I think maybe they had already signed a contract or whatever. I don't know, an agreement of some kind. Maybe money, you know, coins had already been exchanged. And so they just kind of let her come. But I thought, now this to me, one and one makes two to me, y'all. Do you guys understand what I'm saying? I'm not saying that I am definitely right because y'all know I don't work there, okay? I don't have any connections, okay, with any friends of Ebony's. But it just makes sense to me that hearing this person say to the Daily Mail, "We're not going to hire anybody from a Real Housewives series, okay? Okay, then they wouldn't have really let us see her really be. I don't know, guys. I just thought to myself, this is just really sad because this girl, y'all heard that the clip we listened to together the other day when she was on the red carpet. You know, she sounded very confident that she could get this job. And so I'm like, you know what? I think they really strung Ebony along. I really, really do. Guys, I don't think we're going to see Ebony again. Maybe as a guest. You know, maybe next year as a guest co-host, but I don't think we're gonna see her again this season. I really don't, guys. So, guys, I'm gonna let you go. I will keep an eye on this because I really think they did Ebony wrong. And I think Ebony was told one thing and it's really something else. And I don't expect to see her guest co-hosting anymore this season. So, I'll talk to you guys later.
Call my bluff and you wanna be my friend. I'm the one you ride, I'm the one you ride to.